नमस्कार, आयुष दर्पण के इस प्लेटफॉर्म पर मैं डॉक्टर नवीन जोशी आपका बहुत बहुत स्वागत करता हूं और अभिनंदन करता हूं। जैसा कि अभी तक हमने आपको कई कई डिफरेंट लेक्चर्स आपने हमारे साथ देखे होंगे और इन्हीं लेक्चर्स के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में हमने तमाम विभिन्न प्रकार के एक्सपर्ट्स को हमने इस आयुष दर्पण के प्लेटफॉर्म पर आपके समक्ष प्रस्तुत किया है। इसी क्रम में आपने मार्च महीने से अब तक विभिन्न विषयों पर आयुर्वेद के हमने टच किया है, जिनमें काय चिकित्सा हो, चाहे पंचकर्म हो, चाहे मर्म चिकित्सा हो, चाहे नाड़ी विज्ञान हो, चाहे द्रव्यगुण शास्त्र हो या फिर शल्य तंत्र हो, शायद ही कोई ऐसी विधा हो जिसे हमने अपने इन लेक्चर्स में या वेबिनार्स में शायद ही छोड़ा होगा। मेरे पास बहुत सारे फोन आते हैं। अभी अभी 5 मिनट ही पहले कोलकाता से एक फोन आया डॉक्टर का, जिन्होंने बताया कि हम इन वेबिनार से और इन लेक्चर से सर बहुत बहुत अभिभूत हैं और हम आपके लिए कुछ करना चाहते हैं। उन्होंने कहा, मेरे लिए बहुत बड़ी उपलब्धि है कि लोग स्वयं इन लेक्चर्स को देख करके ये कहते हैं कि हम आयुष दर्पण के लिए कुछ करना चाहते हैं। तो मेरा यही कहना है कि आप कुछ मत करिए, आप आयुष दर्पण के साथ बने रहिए और आयुष दर्पण को देखते रहिए। तो अब आज हम इसी कार्यक्रम में आपके समक्ष इंट्रोड्यूस करते हैं, क्योंकि आप लोगों ने बहुत सारे लेक्चर्स देखे होंगे और बहुत इससे पहले एक लेक्चर बॉम्बे हेम्प कंपनी का एक लेक्चर हुआ था, जिसमें भी एक एक्सपर्टीज थी उनकी, जिन्होंने कैनेबिस पे एक लेक्चर दिया था। तो हमने आपको एक ऐसे एक्सपर्ट को हम आपके सामने लेके आ रहे हैं जिन्होंने अपनी कैनेबिस पे ही पीएचडी की है और आज उनका टाइटल जो है वो अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ विजया, जिसे आप जानते हैं कि कैनविस को ही विजया भी कहते हैं, जिसका नाम ही विजया हो वो कितनी जबरदस्त उसका औषधीय प्रयोग होगा फ्रॉम आयुर्वेदिक परस्पेक्टिव। वो आपको आज आयुर्वेदिक परस्पेक्टिव से कैनविस को समझने का आपका नजरिया बदलेगी। तो डॉक्टर स्वागता तवारे जी जो हैं वो एमडी हैं आयुर्वेद से और पीएचडी हैं आईपीटी जीआरए जामनगर से, गुजरात आयुर्वेद जामनगर से। वो असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर हैं डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ द्रव्यगुण में और फिलहाल वो जीजे पटेल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक स्टडीज एंड रिसर्च न्यू बल्लभ भाई विद्यानगर, बल्लभ विद्यानगर आनंद गुजरात में वो पोस्टेड हैं। तो डॉक्टर स्वागता जी, आपका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है। पहले तो हम जब इसका लेक्चर स्टार्ट करें उससे पहले हम आपको आपसे पूछना चाहेंगे, आप एक तो अनम्यूट कर लीजिए अपने आप को, आप ये बताइए कि आपने जो है कैनेबिस पे क्या क्या काम किया है, थोड़ा सा पहले बता दीजिए। हमारे यहाँ बहुत सारे डॉक्टर हैं, स्टूडेंट हैं, वो कैनेबिस के बारे में बहुत सारे सवाल है उनके मन में, तो हम चाहेंगे कि इससे पहले कि आपका प्रेजेंटेशन स्टार्ट हो, तो क्यों आपने कैनेबिस को चुना अपनी पीएचडी की, ये जरा बताइए आप।
सेमा ऑडिबल? ओके
यस, यू आर ऑडिबल।
सर, थैंक यू सर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थैंक्स टू यू दैट यू हैव गिवन मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू टॉक ऑन दिस टॉपिक। सर, रिगार्डिंग पीएचडी वर्क व्हिच आई हैव कंडक्टेड ऑन कैनाबिस, आई हैव गिवन हाइलाइट्स ऑफ दैट वर्क इन माय प्रेजेंटेशन आल्सो, बिकॉज इट्स एन आयुर्वेदिक वर्क वी हैव डन, लाइक सो इन शॉर्ट आई टेल यू दिस टॉपिक आई चूज बिकॉज वी वर लाइक अवर इन अवर इंस्टीट्यूट देर वॉज अ प्रोजेक्ट फॉर अ उपविष ड्रग एंड कैनाबिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द ड्रग विच इज कंसिडर्ड एज ए नार्कोटिक वन एंड इन आयुर्वेदा इट हैज बीन मेंशन दैट द ड्रग शुड बी यूज बाय प्रोसेसिंग दैट इज अ शोधन मेथोडोलॉजी so that is a drug which is not we are not using in the practices. Even the pharmaceutical companies, Ayurvedic pharmaceutical companies which are preparing cannabis medicine, they are just excluding cannabis and rest of the ingredients they are adding, say for example in a Kanaka Sundar Ras or Grahani Vajra Kapat Ras, only the main content which is cannabis that has been excluded because the drug is coming under the NDPS Act, and for the use or practice of this drug one should have some legal licensee which is not given by the government of India, and if at all anybody is using it will be a non-valuable offense. So this drug, we had our pharmacy had a licensee for the productions of this drug, so in continue of that we took a licensee for the research purpose. So and we try to evaluate that after purification whether the cannabis a drug is possessing the same narcotic impact or psychoactive impact, or what is the purpose why classics have advocated cannabis for the use of Vijaya after processing. And there are more than 700 formulations classics are also they have indicated for multiple disease conditions, and the drug is not for use. And now recent researches and research recent trends, it is a going like it's just polarizing cannabis. Like everywhere they are trying clinical trials or preclinical trials for cannabis for multiple disease conditions, rather critical disease conditions. So why we are neglecting this medicine from Ayurveda? So with that purpose, we conducted a short pilot study, a clinical study, and for before reaching to clinical, we did some preclinical analysis and animal study of the same processed cannabis. So that was just a short attempt we tried in my PhD work. Probably now, if the government is allowing permissions, then we can do some mega trials also or multicentric trial also, and then we can come to certain conclusion for herbal cannabis or the processed or shodhit bhanga, what we say in Ayurveda. Can we use it or can we replace that medicine for various conditions like cancer pain is there or ALS is there, or the epileptic conditions are there, for that where we don't have a certain sure shot medicine nowadays up to date. So for that, can a cannabis will be an option. So with that purpose, like underlying that purpose, we kept in mind and we started progress with this work. We got some licenses from the excise department to conduct this work. So what is the work? What are the parameters we tested in my PhD work that I have included in the this presentation also? So we will discuss that later.
Thank you, Dr. Swagata. So I will bring you on this session and you can now start your presentation. Thank you.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Is
visible and you are audible. You can now start. Yeah.
Okay, sir. So we will directly start with the topic, that is understanding of Vijaya or Bhanga, we say in Ayurveda, that is cannabis, like from Ayurvedic perspective, right? So we'll directly touch into the lecture. Sir has given my introduction very well. Thank you, sir. So cannabis, right? This plant is having a long history, that is from before 6,000 years, this plant has been introduced into the pharmacopoeia across the world for various medicinal purposes or economical purposes, or the drug is used as a medicine, right? So why today, now we are in 20th century and we are querying the uses of cannabis, like we are confused whether the drug to be used or not. So this is, at today's date, the cannabis is highly polarized drug. Lots of opinion, scientific opinion, political opinion, all these are confusing the scientific community, or somewhere restricting the scientific community to use this cannabis for the medicine purposes. And what is revolution? Means how this cannabis has, in ancient time, or ancient pharmacopoeias, it was used for medicine, and in between phase that has gone totally isolated from the totally out of the medicine field because of this NDPS Act or many legal conditions which have been forced for the use of this drug across the world. So every country has their own legal restrictions for the use of this drug. So what is the revolution that we will understand first? So initially, in ancient times, we are getting the references that cannabis was used for as oil source, fiber, as a fiber crop, right? For ritualistic purposes in herbal medicine of China, Tibetan, there are lots of uses of cannabis were found. And then it came into the Ayurvedic medicine of India. So in Ayurveda also, the references of cannabis started in Madanpal Nigantu, Shodal Nigantu, and then slowly its uses, therapeutic uses, came into the Chikitsa Grantha. And Rasa Shastra has widely explored the various formulations which they have added cannabis as a main content. Or some, in many formulations, they have used cannabis for the trituration of that particular formulations. So Ayurvedic alchemy, what we say as Rasa Shastra, they have explored cannabis very well. Then we found that it is used for industrial purposes, medicinal purposes in European pharmacopoeia, right? In Egypt also, we found that it has been used in papyrus. So what happened after Second World War, there were new medications came like vaccines, alternative analgesics came into the pharmaceutical industry or the medicine. Then injectables of morphine came, synthetic analgesics, sedatives came, right? All these are the indications, or all these were the purpose for which in ancient time cannabis was used as a medicine. And after Second World War, because of this new emerging medicines, there were a political scenario came that a concern over danger of abuse of cannabis that was focused more rather than its medicinal importance. And then the drug came into Controlled Substance Act in 1970, and thus this drug, that is cannabis or marijuana, it was included under Schedule 1 drug, and it was designated as it has no medicinal value and it has a high potential for abuse under Single Narcotic Convention. So this was a statement, it was raised in the field of medicine, that the drug is not having any medicinal value. In fact, it is a highly abusive drug or the addictive drug. And so its use were debarred. So in now what happened? There were many clinical, preclinical trials were undergoing in between, which were proving the results of cannabis. But it was only under the research purposes. There is always restriction for use of cannabis in for the patients. So in June 2018, the FDA approved Epidiolex, the first prescription of cannabis medication, which contains CBD. Right? And it is used to treat rare, difficult to control forms of epilepsy. So this was the first time that FDA approved for use of drug directly in a clinical directly in the clinical medicines. So US has filed a patent which says that certain parts of marijuana plants can be used as a medicine, but not the whole plant. So reason why cannabis is ignored, rather why it is ignored in India. India is always silent for the use of cannabis for on a patients. So reason being, it is highly confusing drugs. There are lots of researches which are giving the information about its utility in for various clinical conditions or very rare diseases for which there are no medications, right? But at the same time, there are researches which are giving information about its dependency, its withdrawal effect, its narcotic effect, its psychotropic actions. So it is always confusing whether the drug is should be used as a medicine or it should be focused for its psychotropic impact. So it's also ignored by Indian government, and a lot of attention is being given by other countries. Now, at present, the other out of India, there is a lot of researches going for the cannabis, and there are a lot of efforts going for the legalization of the cannabis, or cannabis clinics or marijuana clinics are getting opened out of the India for certain clinical conditions. So it is a therapeutically magical drug. It is having high economical importance. So that's why also industries are in efforts to legalize the medicine. At least they can have some economical gain from these medicines. So reason for rethinking cannabis in the medicine. So cannabis medicine, based medicine have, it's a topic of intense study since endogenous cannabinoid system or anandamide system that was discovered 2 decades ago. So extensive researches are going for the use of cannabis and cannabis related derived products for the betterment of mankind. There's treatment with cannabinoids for a number of medical conditions proving successful clinical outcomes. And Ayurveda also, Ayurveda have advocated a number of disease conditions in which cannabis is used as a single drug or it is used in a ingredient as a formulation. So possibly these are few points for which I feel that we should rethink that can cannabis be also entered into the field of medicines. So Ayurvedic understanding, what work I have done in PhD or what a literature review what I have done that was collected from 27 Nigantus, 9 Sahita Granth, that is a classical text of Ayurveda, 21 Chikitsa Granth, that is Ayurvedic compendium, 36 Rasashastra Grantha and 3 Yoga Grantha. From these sources, I have compiled the description of cannabis, what are the therapeutic effects, how to use, how much long time it to be used, and what are the methods by which cannabis can be used in the patients. So, classification of cannabis or bhang, as per lexicons, we can see that it has been included into the Guruchadi Varga, Lakshmanadi Varga, Haritkyadi Varga, Aushadi Varga, by respective Nigantu, as I have mentioned. Even Shaligram has mentioned it into Ashtavarga. Important point to note here is that no Nigantu have included cannabis or Vijaya under Vishavarga nor under Upavishavarga also. Means they have simply considered Vijaya as normal medicine as they are considering for Haritaki, Amalti or Vivitak, etc. So there is no such indications. There are many Upavish which we are using in a clinical practice, like Eranda is there, Langli is there, Vallatak is there. Same importance they have given for Vijaya, and they have given its purification process, and they have asked it to use with certain precautionary measures. So pharmacodynamic, what Ayurveda is saying, the Rasa is having Tikta, Virya is Ushna, Vipaki is Katu. There is no special weightage is given for cannabis or no major threats has been mentioned by Ayurveda. Certain impacts, psychotropic impacts are there. They have quoted and they have explained that to pacify this impact, the drug should be processed or the use of drug should be after Shodhana. So Doshagnata is mentioned as a Kafavatahar and Pittal. Pittal is it might be considered as a side effect, but that has been also quoted, well quoted. So Karma, cannabis is having Vyavai, Deepana Grahi, Medhya, Rasayan, Vajikaran Karma. And Rogagnata, the classics is saying in Bhav Prakash that it is used for Grahani, Sangrahani, Jwar, Visuchika, Shul and Anidra like condition. Action of mal, it is given, it is grahi and it is a sveda janana drug. And strotas mostly focused is annavaha and shukravaha strotas for the effect of vijaya. Different synonyms what mentioned by classics are vijaya, bhanga, jaya, matulani. These are four synonyms are very widely explained. If you are searching in Ayurvedic literature, you can get any formulation. There might be a name of a drug as Madhini. So you have to consider there it as a Bhanga. Everywhere it is not mentioned as a Vijaya. So these are 33 synonyms you can see in the classical text which indicates that drug is cannabis or that drug is Vijaya. Synonym based on pharmacognostical characters are Matulani, that is male and female flowers are separate. There are two plants, one is male plant, other is female plant. Samvida Manjari, that is flower blooms in a bunches and it's having a inflorescence. Synonyms for CNS effect are also well quoted, that is it is a Bahuvadini or Ganja, so that it creates delirium. It is called as Ananda, Chillada, Harsh. Chini, Madini, Mohini, Ranjika, so which reflects a state of euphoria or hallucination. It is also given one synonym as Tandrakrut, means it is creating drowsiness. Manamohana, it accomplishes the objects of mind. Jaya, it cures the diarrhea. So this is regarding GIT. So effect of or impact of cannabis on CNS is already well quoted in the Ayurveda classics also. Different karma. What is the action of drug? So basically it is Deepan, Pachan, Grahi, Ruchya, Madakari, Balya, Nidra Janan, Vak Vardhana, Garbhapatana, Vedana Shapahara, that is analgesic, Harshana, Harshini, Mutrala, Diuretic, Buddhisruti Krut, Vibhanda Krut, Kama Vega Krut, Medhya, Ruchya. So these are various actions given for the single drug, that is cannabis. So we can see, classify this action according to the system wise. So on integumentary system, we can say that this drug is acting as an astringent, tonic, anti-dandruff or antiseptic. On musculoskeletal system, it is analgesic, antispasmodic. On nervous system, it is narcotic, sedative, stimulant, both effect. Sedative also, stimulant also, depend on the dose, depend on the administration, route of administration. It is a pleasure giving drug. It is intoxicant. It is febrific, hallucinogenic, and it is stupefying. On digestive system, it is good appetizer, antidiarrheal, digestive, antiflatulent, vermicidal, antispasmodic, antiemetic, carminative. On urinary system, it is acting as a diuretic. Reproductive system, aphrodisiac, abortifacient. So these are the various actions given for cannabis. Now, thing is that we have to classify these actions into two ways. One, positive actions which we require for clinical management of certain diseases, and one, certain ADR which are well coded. So if we balance these actions, we are saying that there are more, we can say that there are more positive things for the use of cannabis, more beneficial along with some side effects, right? So these side effects should be pacified or should be lowered by processing techniques which are advised into the Ayurveda classics. The drug is said as Vataka Fahar Pittavardhan. Major for Bhanga Visheshanti means if at all a drug is administered in large amount or misuse of drug has been done, how to manage that has been quoted into the classics. That classics is saying a curd prepared from cow milk should be given with shunti, that is gingiver, dry ginger, what we see. Then a curd prepared from cow milk should be given with gingiver and nimbuswaras, lemon juice. Then curd prepared from cow milk given with ginger and wet root of sandesada. And Durvankur Vati, which is given in Siddha Vaishaj Maniwala, that should be ingested if there is a hangover effect of cannabis. Agonist ras, madhur ras means if cannabis is used along with madhur ras, it gives more impact. Synergism happens. And antagonist drugs, we say it as amla ras, shunti, and curd. These three things reduces the effect of cannabis. Coming to cannabis-based formulations, in Ayurveda classics, there are total 367 formulations are there in which cannabis is used as an ingredient. Out of which major ingredient and minor ingredient, this is some calculations I have done. Out of this 367 formulation, I have gone in each formulation and I have calculated the proportion of cannabis in the that particular formulation. So major ingredient is that that ingredient in which cannabis is either 1:1, 1:2, up to 1:6 part. That is one part of cannabis and six part are other ingredients. And cannabis is as a minor ingredient are the formulation in which the other ingredients are in more proportion than the cannabis in the ratio of more than 1:6. So there are 102 formulations in which cannabis is used as a major ingredient. Like proportion of cannabis in the formulation is more than other contents. There are 91 formulations are there in which cannabis is used as a minor ingredient. Means so certain small amount of cannabis is added into that formulation. 157 formulations are there in which cannabis is used as a levigation media. Means it just trituration is done for that particular rasakalpa. And for 17 formulations are there in which cannabis is used as a for external applications. So internal administration as well as external application, both are recommended by the Ayurveda classics. Important indications of cannabis based formulation. If I saw this 367 formulation, what are the major indications? So out of 367, 68 formulations are indicated for Vajikaran purpose. 37 formulations are indicated for management of Grahani, that is we can correlate with IBS. 33 formulations are indicated for Jwar, that is for the management of fever. 30 for Atisar, diarrheal conditions. 22 for Sangrahan, again we can say correlate it with IBD or malabsorption syndrome. 19 formulation for Rasayan purpose and 8 formulation for both Rasayan as well as Vajikaran purpose. So if we see Ayurveda has quoted this drug certainly for Annavaha Srotas and Shukravaha Srotas Vyadhi. In modern researches, we are saying multi-therapeutic approach for this drug, right? But in Ayurveda, nowhere it is quoted only for epilepsy or for CNS effect or for psychotropic effect. Rather, just it has main focus is Annavaha Srotas and Shukravaha Srotas. Important formulation we will see for Vajikaran, out of this 67, what we 68, what we quoted, certain few important formulations which are repeatedly told by many classics or many rasa shastra grantha or chikitsa grantha that we will focus. That is for Vajikaran, Kameshwar Modak, Bruhat Kameshwar Modak, Madananda Modak, Rati Vallabh Modak, and Vijaya. For Grahani management, Gangadhar Churna is explained, Grahani Vajra Kapat Ras is explained, Lai Churna is explained, Grahani Kapat Ras is explained. For Jwar management, Mruta Sanjeevani Rasa and Bhanga Churna, which is Bharjit, Bharjan of cannabis or Bharjan of Vijaya, is also one of the process of processing, that is Shodhana. For Atisar management, Bhanga Churna, Vijaya Avaleha, Atisar Vidravan Ras, Naga Sundar Ras, and Dadim Avaleha, these are indicated. For Sangrahani management, Grahani Vajrakapat Ras, Grahani Gajendra Vatika, these are the formulations. For Rasayan purpose, Kameshwar Modak, Mahakameshwar Kalpa, Ananda Bhairavi Vatika. And for Rasayan as well as Vajikaran purpose, Kamagni Sandipan Modak, Kameshwar Modak, and Nagya Lakshmivala Ras are indicated. So if we see formulation for GIT, that is Annavasrutas, we can correlate. So there are symptoms, there are certain typical symptoms for which cannabis is indicated. That is Agni Mandya, that is digestive impairment, Ajirna, that is indigestion, Amla Pitta, that is hyperacidity, Atisar, diarrheal condition, Grahani, Sangrahani, Shul, that is pain management, Udar, that is diseases of abdomen, and Parinamshul, we can correlate with peptic ulcer. So here what I shown, that are the cannabis having major ingredient, formulation in which cannabis has a minor ingredient, which is designated as capital M and small m respectively, and cannabis, certain formulation in which cannabis is used as a trituration or a levigation media. So when we are focusing on GI tract, diseases of GI tract, we see that cannabis is mostly used in a major amount in the formulations. So these are the leads for use if we are correlating with certain conditions which have a origin as Annavaha Srotas. So these are the indications for the use of cannabis, say for colon cancer. Various dosage form, rasa, churna, vati, modak, avaleha, gutika, tel, pak, sharbat, gruta, kwath, lep, parpati, putpak, asav, arishta, dhupa form, loha form, bandhana form, mandur vatak, patpottali form, and shak, that is vegetable form. All these various forms are indicated for the cannabis administration. It's not only about the drug to be used in a tablet form. There are various medias. So most commonly used forms of, that is in Ayurveda, that are rasa form, churna, that is powder form, vati, that's tablet form, modak form, avaleha form, gutika, also type of vati, tel form, pak form, or sharbat, or grit form, that is ghee form. So we can see that the extraction of cannabis, as explained in Ayurveda, is in water media, as well as alcohol media, as well as lipid media, and also as a herbo-mineral preparations. So all these form a cannabis can be extracted and can be used as a medicine. Period of administration, how much time a cannabis formulation can be administered? This is major concern now. If at all we are giving cannabis for any critical condition, for how much time we can give and what is the safe time till we can administer that or we can prescribe that drug to the patients. So there are certain time that classics has quoted for certain formulations. From that we can have some conclusion that Kashay Kalpana can be given for 7 days or Asav can be given up to 15 days. Vati can be given up to 42 days. Rasa form, herbal mineral formulations can be given up to 60 days, right? Modaka Kalpana, in which cannabis is triturated with, there are multiple conditions, like if you have multiple for ingredients, if you see any Modaka Kalpana in the Rasa Kalpa, you will see minimum 40 to 50 other ingredients are also there along with cannabis. So certain formulations can be used for a long time, like 380 days or up to 1 year also. Time of administration, how much time of cannabis can be given per day? So we have some references that maximum what we see that classic have indicated to use cannabis once in a day or twice in a day. Rarely for us are one drug, that is Vangeshwar Vati, we found that the drug should be given for 3 times a day. Means the repetition of the drug in a day, that is within 24 hours, it should be maximum twice. There are certain formulations we can see, Madanand Modak, which should be given only in evening time. Right? Raja Yoga, it should be given after 2 hours after the diet. Morning time, Lavika Churna Madan Modak, Kushmanda Pak, Praneshwar Ras, these are the formulations having cannabis as a major ingredient, once in a day. So frequency should be maintained while giving, so that if we are maintaining the proper dose, if we are maintaining proper frequency, and if we are maintaining a correct duration, then there are no chances of side effects. Part of cannabis. What are the different parts that classics have used? So for certain formulation like Gangadhar Churna, Madana Kameshwara Vati, Madana Modaka, Virya Stambhakara Vatika, leaf is used. Formulation like Karpuradya Rasa, Shweta Parajita Nasya Churnam, or Talakeshwar Ras, Chandramrut Ras, seed of cannabis is used. Kamagni Sandipan Ras, Kameshwara Modak, Rati Vallabh Modak, seed as well as leaf, both are used. For Vijaya Bandha, that this is the external application, whole plant is used. And for certain formulation like Madana Modaka, Madana Prasha Churna, Mandyadi Gutika, in this Gruta Parichita cannabis, that is a processed cannabis, has been advised to be used. So nowhere we are, the major concern is because of resinous exudate. That has not been advised by Ayurveda for internal administration. Part of cannabis for levigation of a formulation, we can see leaf is used, seed is used, and seed oil is used. These are having less narcotic contents. So Shodhana, that is an Ayurvedic concept for the use of cannabis into the clinical practice. So purification of cannabis. There are four methods Ayurveda is explaining. First is Jalanimanjan method, which is having principle of immersion. We will discuss later also in detail. Jalaprakshalan, in which cannabis is washed. Godugdha Svedan, in which cannabis is boiled in cow milk. Babultvakvat Svedan, in which cannabis is boiled in the decoction of Acacia arabica. So in first method, that is Jalanimanjan, in which immersion principle is used, these cannabis leaves are tied in potali and that are immersed in water overnight. For 12 hours, we have kept this drug into the water and then remove this drug out of potali, make it dry, and after drying, we have to fry it with cow ghee. Second principle is Prakshalan, that is washing, in which cannabis leaves are thoroughly washed under running water till the greenish color stops oozing from these leaves. So this trichome part of the leaf gets washed in this process, and this trichome is containing certain psychoactive constituents like THC. And then it is dried in the sun. Third method in which Godugdha Svedan, that cannabis is tied in potali of muslin material, and then it is boiled in cow milk for 3 hours. After that, it is washed with water and then dried, and then later it is roasted in ghee. In Babultvakvat fermentation method, it is boiled in Acacia arabica decoction for 12 minutes. After that, it has been dried under sun, and then it is triturated well with cow ghee, and it is made into the fine powder form. So I'll show some slides in which I have done this process of purification of cannabis. See, in first method, this after 12 hours, the removal of cannabis water, we can see this dark water comes out of the leaves, then this dried leaves, we dry it under shade, and then we triturate or we fried it with cow ghee. In Jalaprakshalan, it is continuously washed under water, so that this dark, in third picture, we can see the dark greenish color liquid comes out of the leaf, and that we are throwing, and the last color which is oozing from the leaf should match with the color of water. So till that time you have to wash. Then this cow milk fermentation method, in which we have that potali which consists of cannabis leaf, we have boiled at 100 degrees Celsius for 3 hours, then we washed with water, we dry, and then we triturate with cow ghee. Last method, that is decoction of Acacia arabica, we are frying at 100 degrees Celsius, we are boiling it for 12 minutes, and then we are triturating with cow milk, and the dry powder should be the end point. And this trituration and making it dry, it almost takes 3 days. various recipes that Ayurveda, we are getting in Ayurvedic classics for cannabis. So these are edibles, we can say. Bhang in the form of pakoda, bhang in the form of paratha, or bhang in the form of balls. These are used. So what are part of bhang that are used? That are leaf and seed. So leaf and seed, these are the parts. Now in researches also, they are showing that it has a high nutritional value. So Ayurveda has also, what that method of administering that has been indicated is as a food. Means cannabis was used as a food source also in the Ayurvedic, it has been quoted in Ayurveda also. And in China, it was used as a five grain. Means for those five grains which they have kept as a diet sources, among which one was a cannabis seeds. So modern approach. We will see till time we have seen what is classical description of cannabis. Now we will just shortly correlate with these classical indications with along with modern approaches. So terminologies. First of all, when we are coming into modern science, there is nothing called a single drug like Bhanga or single drug like Vijaya, as we are considered in Ayurveda. So there will be different terminologies, and for each part of that drug, there are certain legal restrictions. So cannabis or marijuana is a correct word given for the plant or its products, or herbal cannabis. Hemp, historically, it is referred as a fiber source, which is having low psychoactive compounds. That is delta THC will be in a low amount and higher concentration of CBD. Ganja, this is a resinous flower shoots of cultivated female plants. And bhang is mature leaves along with certain flowering shoots that is content that can be mixed along with this plant. So nutritional importance of seeds. Seed is very much explored for its nutritional value. So vitamin B complex, vitamin C, vitamin E found in a rich amount in the seed. Minerals like phosphorus, potassium, magnesium, calcium, iron, sodium, manganese, zinc, copper. These we are getting from cannabis seed. Hemp seed is a great source of plant-based proteins. And 2-3 teaspoons contains almost 11 grams of protein. An important thing is that it's zero cholesterol product. Means nowadays we are also hearing news in social media that certain celebrities are using the CBD products. Why? Because it is multi-purpose, that is vitamin, mineral and proteins along with zero cholesterol. So there is no chance of weight gain if you consume the products prepared from the cannabis seed. Nutritional importance, if we calculate, we see that vitamin E out of 100 gram, there is almost 90 milligram. Thiamine, riboflavin is present, phosphorus, potassium, magnesium is in high quantity, potassium is in high quantity. Calcium is 145 milligram per 100 gram. Copper is there. So energy count, if we say that the 100 gram of cannabis seed is giving almost 525 kilocalorie, right? So in out of India where cannabis is legalized, hemp seed butter, it is available. And this is used for as a food source. Economical importance, very important. Most of the half of the pharmaceutical industries are running behind for getting the permission, legal permission for use of cannabis as a medicine. Half of the pharmaceutical, they have approached to use or to get the legal permission because they want to use cannabis for an economical purpose or economical gain. Because cannabis is used as a source of fiber, very good cloth material you can get from this. And of course, these fibers are non-psychoactive. So the industries want this drug to be come out of the legal restrictions and they can use its fibrous part. It is used to make cell, canvas, pants, cloths, shoes, biodiesel, plastic, bioplastics. And it is hemp-made products are eco-friendly. It helps in reduction of CO2, that is carbon dioxide. And cements are also made from the hemp, which are used for the construction. It can be seen in Ajanta, Vellore places. So these are various other non-medicinal uses of cannabis. Classification of cannabis according to phenotype, we see there are three major basic broad types of cannabis. That is, one is drug type, intermediate type, and other is fiber type. Or we can say it as a non-drug type. So there are certain indices given for that particular criteria. So drug type will be having THC, that which is psychoactive, THC greater than CBD. Or THC is to CBD ratio should be greater than 1. Intermediate type is in between the drug time and fiber time, which is having CBD as a major content. CBD is non-psychoactive, but there are traces of THC we will find in that products or in that drug type. Fiber type, especially THC should be less than 1%. That is a criteria. It has a very low THC and it's mostly non-drug. It is used for an industrial purpose or the economical purpose. Preparation of plastics, preparation of canvas, preparation of cements, this can be derived from the third type. Leaf pattern, you can see sativa species, cannabis indica species, cannabis ruderalis. These are the major three species they are getting researched upon. Important phytoconstituent. This is very important from scientific angle or clinical angle. The THC, main psychoactive component, it is responsible for high. But there are certain clinical indications like pain, muscle spasticity, insomnia, as a loss of appetite, is the nausea, anxiety, for which scientists are demanding to make THC also out of legal restrictions. CBD, that content is non-psychoactive. It does not create high. It has a physical benefits like reducing pain, nausea, preventing seizures, inflammation, that is anti-inflammatory. It is indicated for psychosis, mental disorders, irritable bowel syndrome, depression, anxiety, and migraine purposes. Both drugs are acting through endocannabinoid systems, but action of CBD is different from the action of THC. CBN, it is mildly psychoactive and it's a degradation product of tetrahydrocannabinoic acid. It does not create high. It is used to ease the symptoms and side effects of neurological conditions like epilepsy, seizures, or uncontrollable muscle stiffness. THCA, this is also non-psychoactive. It does not create high. It reduces inflammation from arthritis or autoimmune diseases. Right? It helps to reduce the symptoms of neurological conditions like Parkinsonism and ALS. CBG, that is cannabigriol, it is also non-psychoactive. It is precursor of THC and CBD. It does not create high. It reduces anxiety, symptoms of obsessive compulsive disorders, post-traumatic stress disorders, and depression. So if we look at the phytoconstituent, which we are getting into the plant of cannabis, THC is the major concern. Because of that, drug is under the NDPS Act. But rest of the constituent, that is CBD, CBN, THC, CBG, which are non-psychoactive, which does not create high, and they have multiple therapeutic effects. Like there are certain conditions like epilepsy, cancer, pain, seizures, autoimmune diseases, Parkinson's, ALS, for which these are the magical remedies. But as because of THC, the drug is under NDPS or drug is under legal restrictions, we are not able to use drug for the clinical practice. Now, if we see modern researches of cannabis for pain management, previously we saw Ayurvedic, it was indicated for Vajikaran, Rasaya, Grahani, Sangrahani. In modern, it has been explored for pain management, cancer pain management. You can see number of clinical trials. This trial's record is up to 2019. Nausea, vomiting, multiple sclerosis, these are almost 61 trials are conducted for multiple sclerosis. Spasticity, 50 trials are conducted. Cancer chemotherapy, withdrawal symptoms, and use of cannabis into particular diseases, 47 trials are there. Appetite loss, 40 trials are there. For HIV, AIDS as a medication, 30 trials are there. Dependency studies are also there, 28 trials are there. For epilepsy management, 26 trials are there. You can see indications. If you see indications, these are indications which are real concern for the clinical practice. Anxiety, depression, spinal cord injury, Parkinson's, Tourette syndrome, post-traumatic stress disorder, psychosis, glaucoma, inflammation, dystonia, GIT disorders, sleep disorders, Alzheimer's, bipolar disorders, OCPD, traumatic brain injury, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, that is ALS, Huntington's disease. So these are the certain rare conditions of clinical medicine which we require certain drug which may create a magical impact into the patients. So that has been explored by the modern science. And there are almost more than 757 plus trials, clinical trials on the cannabis. So all these trials are conducted with the permission of research. But conclusion is that we cannot use a practitioner cannot use drug for the patients because it is under the legal restrictions. Clinical trial for cancer pain, we are not going into detail. Already we have discussed. There are certain references I have covered. Clinical trials are conducted for a pediatric epilepsy. for cancer chemotherapy, CIN, that is cancer-induced nausea, chemotherapy-induced nausea, chemotherapy-induced vomiting. Because of cancer, there is severe appetite loss is there. Depression is there. For that, cannabis is useful. So major cannabis sativa, if we conclude, then we are categorizing into hemp and marijuana. So hemp, we are getting CBD. From marijuana, we are concerning about THC. CBD is non-psychoactive, THC is highly psychoactive. And this is out of India status. CBD is certain, in certain countries, it is legal. THC is yet illegal. In India, THC, CBD, everything is illegal. You cannot use it. So there are two scientific opinions that at least a CBD part of medicine should be legalized. For THC, there can be certain legal restrictions. So always there will be a debate, scientific debate regarding CBD versus THC. So what are different criteria in which we can compare these components of the same plant? That is, CBD is not creating high, THC creating high. What are the same similar points in which we can replace CBD? We can replace THC by CBD. That is, it has pain relief action, it reduces nausea, it is useful for migraine management, it reduces anxiety, increases appetite, that is in THC, but it is absent in CBD. Both are anti-inflammatory. Thing is that if you do the drug test, both for CBD, for THC, both will be in, you can trace both molecule. Though CBD is non-psychoactive, it is traced into the blood. So side effect wise, if we see, THC is having reasonably more side effect as compared to CBD. Legal, illegal concern is there in India. CBD is illegal, THC is illegal. So anandamide system, this is a magical innovation. Why cannabis is coming frequently into the research or frequently into the medicinal importance? Because of this anandamide system, which was invented 2 decades ago. And this effect, anandamide, it is having effect on central as well as peripheral nervous system. It is mediated primarily by CB1 receptor in the CNS and CB2 receptor in the periphery. CB2 receptor helps to activate the immune system. This is very important aspect of this anandamide system, that it helps to improve the immunity of a person. And this sensitivity of THC, which is a primary psychoactive cannabinoids, it is found in the cannabis. And this receptor, CB1 and CB2, are sensitive to this THC component. This anandamide system plays a role in regulation of feeding behavior, neural regeneration, motivation, and pleasure. So that's why these are used in depression, psychosis-like conditions. Peak plasma level of anandamide occurs at ovulation, and it positively correlates with the peak of estradiol, gonadotropins, and it suggests that this may be involved in the regulation of anandamide methods. So the role of reproductive systems or the hormones. So this system is impacting overall your CNS, hormones, GIT, and out of over to that, it creates certain some different pleasure into the person who is administering the cannabis. So we can see now anandamide system is very well explored, that it is having an attractive therapeutic approach for cardiovascular diseases. Uncontrollable hypertension can be managed by giving the cannabis. And endocannabinoid system is helped to regulation of mammalian cell apoptosis. This might be the reason it is extensively used for the cancer researches. New role of anandamide, that is a defective link between systemic skin and endocannabinoid hypertrophic human wound healing, that this drug is used for fibrotic, where the fibrosis has happened. So in that conditions, the cannabis is used. The role of endocannabinoid system in female reproductive issues for controlling the hormone, for controlling folliculogenesis, oocyte maturation, ovarian endocrine secretions. So this whole axis is well managed by the influence of endocannabinoid system and on the reproductive system. A new role of endocannabinoid, which is a defective link in between, again, the same slide came, hypertrophic human wound healing. We'll just shortly, I'll discuss what the clinical trial I have conducted on cannabis. We have conducted the processed cannabis we use in patients of cancer pain with the aim to validate the role of shodhana of cannabis in improving the quality of life in cancer patients, special reference to pain management. The selection of patients were done from the OPD of CCRS unit of a cancer that is situated in Mumbai, Worli. We have procured patients which are already diagnosed as a cancer having pain with deprived quality of life. Materials method inclusion criteria we did 18 to 60 years of either sex, which might undergoing the standard palliative treatment care for cancer management, and those who are willing to come under the trial after the information that the about the drug to the patients. Exclusion criteria, we exclude the patients of uncontrolled hypertension, uncontrolled diabetes, heart diseases, lung diseases. Pregnancy, breastfeeding women were excluded. Patients with inability to complete the study protocol. There were many patients which were from all over India. We got patients, like the trial unit was in Mumbai, but we got patients from Bengal, we got patients from Ranchi. So these patients were not able to give the proper follow-up every week. So sir, these patients were excluded from the trial, and only those patients which will give us follow-up every week, that patients were included for the study purpose. Sample size calculation, for pilot study we calculated sample size as a 40. Study design, it was a pilot trial. The study period we kept as a 9 months. Test drug, processed cannabis, which we have processed by Jala Prakshalan method. That was given into 250 milligram in a capsule form. And a vehicle, that is Anupan, we give as a 1 cup of cow milk with addition of sugar. Time of administration we kept as a 9, morning 9, night 9, and in between 3 p.m. 250 milligram single tablet we have given. Treatment period for 1 month, and follow-up period every 7 days we took the follow-up of a patient. So that if at all any other symptom or unwanted side effect, if at all a patient is might be raised, the complaint is there, that we can monitor it. So we have kept the short duration follow-ups. So total enrolled patients were 37. Almost 13 patients dropped out because there were many reasons. Certain patients were going chemotherapy. They had a chemotherapy cycle, radiation cycle. So we drop out that patients, and we have posted them for chemo radiation. Long distance patients were dropped out from the 80 follow-up. Scoring pattern we kept for pain management, validated scale like Wong-Baker facies pain scale, assessment scale.
Time can include, yeah.
Okay, sir. 2 minutes. Neuropathic pain scale, anxiety, depression, we assist, quality of life, we assist, then ECOG score or WHO score, we assist for the performance status of that cancer patients and certain associated symptoms, along with the main complaint, that is cancer pain, we have included into the our pro forma. Precautions, we told to the patients not to travel alone, right, and not to administer drug by their own way. Whatever indicated, what are the indications or what are the instructions we have given, that have to the, that should be followed by the patients. Drug compliance form has been given to the patients. Only 21 tablets per week we have provided to the patients. Statistical, when we saw, we got significant effect on pain management, anxiety, depressions. Only we did not found a good statistical significant result on social parameter of the quality of life patient. Otherwise, the emotional well-being, functional well-being, quality of life, performance status of the patients, we found the statistically significant. Associated complaints like Agni Mandya, for which cannabis is well indicated in Ayurveda also, that we got the good results on that parameter. Nausea, constipation, feverish feeling, insomnia kind of feelings, that patients, that these of the symptoms were well improved. There were no post-withdrawal effects of the processed cannabis, what we found. After 1 month administration, patient was not having any dependency because of the medicine. There were no ADR. Mechanism, we can say that from Ayurvedic perspective, cannabis is Gangai's Ushnavirya drug. It is Vyavayi, that is short acting. So it is relieving the pain instantly. It is Shukral Vrishya Vajikaran in action. It is Ojavardhak. So it is helping in reducing the anxiety or depression-like conditions. it is param rasayana, it is a balya, so it enhances the quality of dhatu, and it is a nidra janan. So sedation is one type of analgesia, so with that quality or with that action also the drug is helping as a analgesic. So from if we conclude a cannabis in nutshell, this lecture if we see, there are almost 67 indication of cannabis in Ayurveda, almost 17 pharmacological actions are there. If we see formulations review, we are getting 367 formulation, out of which 116 are having cannabis as a major ingredient, 85 having cannabis as a minor ingredient, 163 formulation in which cannabis is used as a trituration media. There are 49 different vehicles are used or anupana are advised to administer the cannabis. There are almost 489 chemical constituents, out of which 70 cannabinoids categories are there. Right, preclinical researches, clinical researches, there are total more than 757 plus researches on cannabis. Cannabis can be used as a diet, cannabis can be used as a medicine, cannabis can be used as a cosmetic, cannabis can be used for economy, cannabis can be used for fiber oil production, cannabis can be used as a vehicle for administration of other drugs. Thank you. Important note in that, sir, please let me say this. Cannabis is not yet legal in India, so its use is strictly prohibited, and this lecture we have conducted, it's only for the knowledge purpose, and yes, no listener should use it without any legal permissions.
Jaisa ki, yes, yes, Swagata ji ne kaha ki ye jo abhi lecture tha, Swagata ji ka ye lecture purpose se hai. Cannabis jo hai wo bhi ek prakar se hum ki nashe mein वाली एक हर्बल एलिमेंट है, इसलिए जो भी आपने यहाँ पे जानकारी ली है इसी प्रकार से इसका प्रयोग स्वयं नहीं करेंगे और नशे के रूप में इसका इस्तेमाल नहीं करेंगे. ये जो लेक्चर दिया गया केवल और केवल एकेडमिक पर्पस. डॉक्टर स्वागता जी, कैनबिस जैसे टॉपिक पर आपने इतना अच्छा प्रेजेंटेशन दिया, योर ब्यूटिफुल प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन दिस प्लेटफॉर्म, आई एम थैंकफुल टू यू, एंड डेफिनेटली दिस इज अ वेरी गुड. Thanks to all of our all of the viewers who are in this Facebook page, and definitely we will bring another speaker in the next few lectures. There are so many lectures in this year, main umeed karta hu ki aap sabhi hamare sath bane rahenge. Bahut bahut dhanyawad. Namaskar ji, swagata ji.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, and main just आपसे फिर आपसे मिलेंगे और हम बंद करते हैं. स्वागत है जी, यू आर नाउ होस्ट, जस्ट मी अ होस्ट, देन आई ओनली कैन क्लोज. आप मुझे होस्ट बना दीजिए. स्वागत चलिए. एनीवे, यस, ओके.